السلام عليكم ورحمة الله to everyone. It is me, Dr. Mohammed Osman, came back again. This lectures is like a tutorial solving a problem in the unit 2, transfer functions and block diagram algebra. So let us see the first problem. Let us have this example. Simplify the following block diagram, then obtain the closed loop transfer function. Okay, the inlet, the input is EI, and the output is EO. But we need to find the relation between EO and E. This one, the transfer functions. Okay. Such a system, it is difficult to reduce it because it is a nested one. يعني متشعب شوية. لو ملاحظ دي الكتلة دي ما ممكن ما بيعتبرها closed loop system الآن. الدائرة دي the circuit is not a closed loop because there is a branch here. يعني أنا ما ممكن أتعامل معاه closed loop وبعدين أجي أقول والله يا أخي ال transfer function بتاعي يساوي شنو؟ G divided by 1 plus gh واحول له كتله واحده. لا، لان الكلوس لوب ممكن تتحول لكتله واحده. واستخدم القانون بتاع الترانسفير فيشن بتاع الكلوس لوب سيستم equal to g divided by 1 plus gh. ليه؟ لانك انت لو حولته لكتله واحده بتلقى صعوبه هتخط البرانش وين في الكتله؟ هل هتخطها بعد الكتله ولا بعد ولا قبل الكتله؟ لأنه هي طالعة من نص السيستم هنا، وهنا برضو نفس الحكاية. الكتلة دي ال summing point، this summing point you cannot consider this as a closed loop system now because there is a summing point here. Because if you consider this a closed loop system, so you can now you can simplify it in one block. If you simplify it in one block, where you can going to put this summing point? You cannot put a summing point inside the block. So for this reason, we need to move this outside here. This one, either before it or merge it here with this one or after it, because summing point can move relative to each other. Here, this also, I have to move it outside from here and put it here, either to put it here before this summing branch, or at this pickup point, or after that. At any point, I can put it here. Okay. If I move this branch from here, so these two blocks are in cascade, so I can multiply G1 and G2 and put it one block. And if I move this from here to here, so these two will be in series or in cascade situation, so I can multiply them G1 and G2 and put it in one block. Okay, so now let us consider to move this one outside here and this outside here. So this will be one block and this will be one block. So let us see how can we reduce this one. Okay, now G1 and G2, I can multiply them together. G1 and G2, I can put them in one block like this one. Okay, after that, see, and this is the system here, and here this is the UAB, isn't it? Here also, there is a summing point, this summing point. G3 and G4, also I can multiply because I move this outside here, this summing point, I move it from here. So G3 and G4 can be in one block. G3, G4, I can put them like this one. Okay, and here we can have E out from here. I can draw the circuit like that. What about this one? This branch? This branch. Here, this summing point, this branch point or pickup point, I move it from here to here. I put it behind the block. When I take here in this system, this signal is taken before it be multiplied by G4. But if you put it, I take it from here. So this means that already you multiply it by G4, you have to divide by G4 here like this one. Because you multiply by G4, come outside here, divided by G4, so it will come here exactly without any change. So here, from here, I can take, let me here. So I divide it by 1 over G4. So the signal would be like that. Okay, this summing point, I move it from to here. This signal, the actual signal is coming here. From here, it will come and multiply by G2 and continue its way. But if you put it here, it will be multiplied by G1. And this is not the case. So in this case, I have to divide it first here by G1. Move it from here, divide it by G1. After that, multiply it by G2 is the same as the previous. Okay, so now this signal I have to divide it by G1. I have to divide it by G1 before I put it here. I can put it here inside this one or before or after here. No problems. But just for simplifications, it is better like this one. So this is EI. You see, this block, this summing point, this summing point can be, can merge it here or can put it here before. So you can move them relative to each other, no problem. But here will be more simple. Here, this system here, this is a closed loop system. And here is a negative sign, negative feedback. You see, both feedback as negative feedback. This is a negative feedback, and this is also a negative feedback. Okay, and this is also a negative feedback. From here, you see, this one is a closed loop system, and this one is a closed loop system. This is a G, and the H here is 0, and the H, the H here is equal to 1. And the H here is equal to 1, because if there is no H, this means that the H is 1. So this system from here, this is a dot line here. This is a closed loop system. I can reduce them in one block equal to G plus divided by 1 plus GH. If you remember, the transfer function of the closed loop system is equal to G divided by 1 plus GH. Like that one. This is the transfer function of the closed loop. So here the G is equal G1 plus G2. G1 multiplied by G2, divided by 1 plus GH. The GH, this is the G, and this is the H. The H is equal to 1, so multiply by 1. No need to write 1. So this is a block diagram. This is for this block. And for this block, the closed loop system, also the H is equal to 1. This one, I can put it like that. This in one block is equal to G3, G4. This is the G divided 1 plus GH, 1 plus G is equal G3, G4. The H is equal 1. So no need to write 1. So it is, will be like this one. This one. So this is the block, will be the two blocks like that one. And this branch This is also a closed loop branch. Here, and came back here. This is a closed loop system. So I can put it at the top, or maybe I can put it at the bottom here if I need. I can find it here. Here you have 1 over G four and 1 over G2. They are in cascade position. So I can write G1 and G4, 1 over G1, G4, and multiply them together. Put it, this is the H, you see, and here negative feedback. This is the E. So this is a negative feedback here. This system, this one, negative feedback. Just I put it from the top, I put it bottom here. So here, if you want to find the transfer functions of this one, so also you have to multiply this one, this block, multiply it by this, multiply this block by this block. So if you multiply them together, will be the G, the total G for the system, and this is the H, this is our H. So you can apply the transfer functions for this closed loop system. So it is easy from here if you have, if you are experienced, so you can easy to calculate it. Immediately from here, I can write the transfer, the final transfer function. But for you, you have to first multiply this by this one and put it here. After that, apply this rule. So the G is equal to the multiplication of this is the G divided by 1 plus GH. The GH also, this is the G multiplication of this one. And the H is equal to 1 over G1. Okay. For this one, I can find immediately, for me, I can find the transfer function immediately from here. For me, I can write immediately the transfer functions for this one. So the transfer functions, the closed loop transfer function for this system is equal to, I can write it because it is a long equation. So it will be G1, G2, this 2, this G1, G2, and G3, G4, multiplied by this one, G1, G4, so G1 square, G4 will be also square, divided by this one, multiplied by this one, so it's equal to 1, plus G1, G2, multiplied by 1 plus G3, G4, plus G1, G2, this one, G1, G2, G3, G4, G1, G2, G3, G4, and multiply again by this one, multiply by this one, this one, G1 here, this one is equal to G1 G4 G4. Okay, from here you can reduce it, because here you have G1 G4 here you have G1 G4, remove this G1 G4, remove this G1 square, and sorry, this is square, and remove this square outside. So the remaining will be the transfer functions. Your answer should be like this one, is equal to, your answer should be the transfer functions is equal to G1 G2 G3 G4 divided by 1 plus G1 G2 bracket, multiply by 1 plus G3 G4, multiply by G2 G3. So This is how you can reduce the complicated system like this and reduce it in a simple block diagram. If you they ask you to simplify the block diagram, just draw these diagrams, and these two cascade blocks, you can merge them in one block and leave it like that. Or this is the transfer function here. You just say that this is this value, you have to put this value in one block. This value, this transfer functions, this is, you can put it in one block like that. So you can say this is the reduce block diagram. This is out, and this is in, and here is the transfer functions. This is one block, G1, G2, G3, G4, divided by 1 plus G1, G2, G3, 1 plus G3, G4, G3, G4, plus G3, G4. This is the reduced block diagram, and this is the transfer. The value inside is the transfer functions, and the block is the reduced block diagram. Okay. Here another examples, diagram simplifications. We have the block diagram of a given system is shown below. This is the block diagram. Also, it is a nested complicated here. So we need to reduce it and to obtain the transfer functions between the output and the input. This is the output C and the R is the input. So this means that obtain C over R. This means that obtains the transfer function of the whole system. Here, you see, the rule here knows that the only movement between two summing is between two summing point and branch point is valid. This means that if you want to move summing points, so this summing point and this summing point, you can move them relative to each other. Okay, yeah, you can move this near this one, and you can merge it, and you can put it before, no problems. This branch, you can move it towards the other branch. You can move it here, you can move it here, exactly here, you can move it outside here. It is up to you, okay? But you cannot move the summing point between, the movement is not valid between the summing point and branch point. Never move this relative to each other. If you find these two near each other, you have to separate them. You have to move this in this direction, and you have to move this in this direction, but you cannot move this here to pass the summing point, cannot pass the branch point, never. Okay, so the only movement here is to move this one from here and bring it here if you want. And this bring it here. So the best way is to move this one from here and put it here. So it will simplify for you. So this will be the closed loop system. Okay. This will be a closed loop system. After that, it will be solved easily. Okay. Here, if I want here to move this one, it is better for me to move this one, take it outside from here. And the system, I want to move it here. I want to move it here. This one. Here. If I want to move it here, so I have to divide it by 1 over G3. G2, sorry. If I take the signal from here, I take the signal from here, and bring it here, will be different from taking the signal from here. Because if I take the signal from here, the same signal will be multiplied by G2, and then after that I take it here. So I have to take, after it multiplied by G2, I have to divide it by G2. Divided by G2, like that. So this is will be our system like that. So this one, now this is this one. This one now is a closed loop system. The H is equal, H is equal to 1 because there is no value here, so the H is equal to 1. So the transfer functions here will be equal to like that one. You see the system in dot line, I can reduce it to G2 divided by 1 plus GH. The G is G2, the H is equal to 1. So this is a closed loop system for this one. I apply G divided by G, 1 plus GH for a closed loop transfer functions. Transfer functions is equal to this one. So I apply this. So this is the G and this is the H is equal, so the system would be reduced like this one. Okay. Here, the whole system here, and there is a G1 here. Here G1. Here a G1. You see? And here, from here, you have here H. You have here H1 at the top. Bring it here. And I have again here from the bottom, I have this one here. So this one I can put it at the top also if I want. Okay. Or you can see this one. This is the H. I want to erase this one. Let us have another example of some complicated system. The block diagram of a given system is shown below. Obtain the C over R. This means that obtain the transfer functions, because C over R is the output divided by input. This means that this is the transfer function. So obtain the C over R or obtain the C, the transfer functions is the same meaning. If exists a branch, this is a rule, between two summing points, don't move them. And if they can in the branch, between two summing points, متحرك البرانش. يعني البرانش ده ما هيطلع من التو summing point. لا يطلع منهم يمين ولا يسار. والعكس برضو. If exists a summing point between two branch point, don't move them. The index summing point or two branches, don't move them. Okay? يعني ما بتطلعهم ما ممكن يطلعوا برا. مثلا زي ده هسا ده summing point, the summing point ودي summing point ودي branch. البرانش دي ما ممكن اطلعها برا خالص, ما ممكن اطلعها برا. اوكي, ودايما عندك زي دي branch وsumming point يستحيل تحولهم, يعني شنو relative to each others. فدايما لما يكون عندك وضع زي ده حاول تبعد واحده من الثانيه, لانك ما ممكن تقدم دي او تاخرها خالص. فممكن تشيل اللي توديها قدام او تشيل اللي توديها شنو يبقى كده. فزي سيستم زي ده ما بتقدر تحله, لانه حسه دي فيد فورورد مع دي. ممكن تقول والله دي السيجنال دي زائد دي نجمعهم مع بعض, لانه دي بالبلس ودي برضه لازم يكون. طبعا ما ادينك اشاره معناته البلس, ما ممكن لانه في برانش هنا طالع. هنا برضو عايز تقول closed loop system, this is a closed loop system. No, it is not a closed loop. It's not like that. No, not a simple one. Because there is a big point here, our branch point هنا. السيستم ده برضو our closed loop system ده من هنا لهنا ده 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 برضو it is not a closed loop system a simple one because there is a summing point here and there is a branch point inside it. So it is difficult to deal with this one. Now the best way to solve this one is to move it is not wise to move it near this the branch near the summing point because it will complicate for you the problem. Now, always if you have summing point and branch point, move them away from each other, but don't move them towards each other. It will complicate your system. It is better to move this from here and put it here. If I move it from here and put it here, you see, because I bring it near this branch, because I have a branch here, so no problems, because I want to take this branch outside from here and put it here also. Okay, this summing point, I want to move it to this point here, either put it before or merge it here or after, no problems. But and this one, I have to bring it here. Okay, if I want to bring this branch here, you see the signal here, the first signal is multiplied by G2. After that, I take the signal. But if I take the branch from here, this means that I have to multiply, because it is before it multiplied by G2, I take it. So I have to multiply it by G2, because this signal is already multiplied by G2. If I take it from here, it will not be multiplied by G2, so I have to multiply it by G2. So I have to put G2 here. Okay, I have to put G2 in this one, so I can multiply the H by G2. Okay, this one, I have to move it here and put it, merge it here. Merge it here. If I move it from here and put it here, because I am put it ahead of the block, so I have to divide it by G, because here it will be multiplied by G. If I move it here, it will be multiplied by G1, but actually it is not multiplied by G1, so I have to divide it by G1 first. After that, if it multiplied by G1, so it will cancel the 1 over G. Okay, so this is the two points I want to move here, so the system will reduce like this one. Okay, so I have now G4, this is G4, and here G2 and G3, because I want to move this one from here, I'll put it here. This means that G2 and G3 can be one block. I can multiply them together. G2 multiplied by G3 can be one block like that. So there's a summing point here. This one, this system. If I move this one here, here, this one, I move it here. So actually, this signal should be multiplied by G2. But if I move it, I put it here like that one. I put it here, so I have to multiply it by G2 here, G2 here. So G2 and H1 together, so it will be here. I can take from here a signal G2 and H1. G2 and H1, I multiply this together. And here, this is G1. In its place, and here is the summing point. This is the summing point, this one, this branch one, and this is the up. Okay, from here, this summing point here, I have a branch again. I have this one, this branch, this one. This branch I will take it from here, this one. I want to put it here. So this signal, if I move it here ahead of this block, so I have to divide this one by 1 over G1. Because I have to put 1 over G1 here. After that, it will enter here this block, this summing point. After that, it multiply by G1. So the G1 will cancel by this G1. So from here, you see, this is the summing point. This is the hedge. Instead of taking it here, just take it outside here. Here. Ferris divided by 1 over G1. Here. And put it here. Put it inside this one, or can I make another one here? If you want. No problems. So this is the G2. Sorry, multiply by G. This is multiply, this is a G1 multiplied by H2, and here also H2. So this one can be G1 and H2 like that. G1 and H2 can multiply them together and can put them like this one. Okay. So this is this one, this one, this one, this one. This one, you can take it from here or from outside here. See, I can take it from here, same positions, and bring it outside here. I can put it here, here inside this one, or can I make another summing point? Because you know that the summing point, you can, this is the R will be here. Okay, this is the R will be here. Or this is negative feedback. This is negative feedback because this is negative. And this is the first one, also negative. All of them are negative feedback. Here, this one is positive, and here no sign. This means that it is positive. So this is a positive, and here also is a positive. So the system can be like that one. You see, these two, this branch, G4, this G4 and G2 and G3, I can sum them because it is a feed forward branches. So you can add them together. Can be G4 plus G2 plus G2 G3 will be G4. Sorry, G4 plus G2 G3. This one. This system. System, so I can make this like this one. Okay, you see, I can replace this one by this value. I can replace it by this value. By this value. This value, I bring it here. So it is G4 plus G2 G3. And this is the C. This is the system. Now, this one, a closed loop system. This one is a closed loop system. This one is a closed loop system, and the transfer of this closed loop system is equal 1 equal G divided by 1 plus GH, and the G is equal to G1, and the H is equal G2H1. This means that if you is equal the G is equal G1. This is the G1. And the H is equal, this is the H, the feedback, GH. So divided by 1 plus G1 the g is g1 and the h is equal g2h1. This is the h for this block diagram. So this one, the block diagram will be reduced like this one. So this system, all this, I can take it out, and replace it by this value. So here, I can erase this one. Let's place it by so just I can put here the value. I can put this value here equal g1 divided by 1 here equal g1 divided by 1 plus g1 g2 h1. This is the system will be reduced like this one. These two are this block. And this block, these two blocks, these blocks are in cascade. You can multiply them to each other. So I can multiply this block to this block. Okay. And the multiplications will be just I can put here. This one can be multiplied by this one. So I can put this one G4 like this also. Sorry. If I want to multiply these two blocks together, so I just remove this one. Yes, I want to take this block. So it is G1, G4, plus G2, G3. So this is a block will be like that. So this already we cancel it. Like this. So you can proceed like this. Okay. Again, this system, this is a closed loop system. You can move this from here, this one, this branch, take it here, put it outside here, so it will be easy for you to see it. So this is the capital G. I can use the same equations. The transfer function is equal for a closed loop is equal GH, like this one. So this is a G, and this is a H. So just use these equations. And we'll find the closed loop like that one. And also here, before you take this one, because if you do this one, again, you need to do another loop here, outside here, another closed loop system. But since these are two, this block, this line and this line, they start at the same point as end at the same point, so you can add them together. Here is h equal to 1, and here g plus h. So these two branches can be 1 plus g, sorry, 1 plus h, sorry, it's equal to 1 plus h2 divided by g1. Because this branch, this you have two branches. One branch starts from here, equal, and the other branch starts from here, and both of them are enter the summing point here, negative. So this one having the value equal h divided by g1, and this is equal to 1. So the summing point you can sum, because it is this one is coming here and this one is coming here, so the summation of these two can give you this value here. Okay, after that, so this will be the new H for the whole system. So you can proceed like that until you finish your simplifications. So try it and see how the answers will be. Okay. So it is, you need to train yourself on this. It is very easy. It is very easy. You have to train yourself and solve a lot of problems. So you'll find it very easy and very simple. This is the end of the class for the today. Let us meet next lecture, also solving problems in the transfer functions and block diagrams. Assalamu alaikum.